fight this beast here. I must make for higher ground.
And pieces around and created whole new scenes.
Wow.
We were efficient. I adopted that technique to my wardrobe too. If you mixed and matched efficiently, you could get by for a year.
Whoa, my bad. Don't worry, I have the right clip now. I think.
This beast here. I must make for higher ground.
Bits and pieces around and created whole new scenes. We were efficient. I adopted that technique to my wardrobe too. If you mixed and matched efficiently, you could get by for years on only a handful of shirts and underwear.
so many scenes of your actors dying. I know.
Why?
When they take a shot from a monster and shoot it right back at him. In my professional opinion, that is the coolest of the cool. Hey, Patrick, throw something at me real quick.
What? I'm sorry, sir, but I don't think that would be appropriate.
You're no fun. I can never get enough of these free-falling shots. Something so invigorating and freeing about them. Like sticking your head out of the sunroof while driving on the freeway. This creature to reflect the human condition, always hungry, never satisfied, the bottomless pit of the beast's stomach. I don't know, you say stuff like that in interviews and your film always wins awards. Oh yeah, another sea monster shot. Another sea monster shot. Modern science fiction directors sometimes put the lens flare in on purpose. Why on earth? What's the next trend? Dead fly on the lens? Jeez. Watch. You won't believe me, but you just watch. It'll happen. Some big shot will do it for one scene, and the following year, everyone will be doing it.
Bye.